Need to manage planning activities by multiple participants across your organization? You can use the integrated calendar in SAP Analytics Cloud to generate and administer key tasks in your planning processes. The calendar uses a combination of two types of events to manage work: processes, which are high-level objects that contain a range of activities, and various types of tasks, which are individual duties that can be assigned to and completed by specific users to contribute to the overall process. You can create these events manually or take advantage of a wizard tool to generate your events automatically. The first step is to set up the overarching process that will contain all the related tasks by defining the name and the start and due dates. You can choose whether you want these events to be activated automatically when the start date is reached. You can also attach any related files that the users to which the tasks are assigned will use to complete the work. Next, you can choose an underlying model. This is used to provide the dimension that will be used to assign the auto-generated tasks. For planning activities, the model should be set for planning purposes. If data locking is part of the process, that also needs to be enabled in the model. The data lock configuration for the relevant dimensions is defined here. If you want the task to be assigned automatically to users or teams, the model also needs to contain a dimension that has users or teams associated with one of its properties, such as person responsible. You can choose the driving dimension here. The wizard will generate a new event for each member that you select. If you turn on the Include Child Members when selecting a parent member option, the events will be generated for each member of the driving dimension, and the work files of each event will be filtered according to the corresponding member. If desired, you can also apply additional filters to limit the context of the tasks based on other dimensions. Now you can define the task types you want to generate. You can choose to generate one general task, which will be generated for each leaf member. Or you can select a calendar template to define the event types and their structure. Remember that you can select only those templates that you have access to, and it can contain no more than 20 events. You also have the option to generate one composite task for each member. However, this option will be deprecated in the future, so it's recommended that you use the other options instead. You can add an automatic data locking task before and after the general or composite task. Want a better overview of the generated tasks? Select the Create a Process for Groups of Tasks option to organize tasks into member-specific groups within a process. You can have the tasks automatically assigned to or reviewed by users by specifying the property of the driving dimension that contains the relevant user IDs. Additionally, you can add individual users or teams for each role and event type. If you've chosen to generate the event types based on a template, the information about users and teams is pre-filled as defined in the template. Next, you can adjust how the task will be named. By default, the relevant member description is appended to the process name. Here, you can also review or change the default suffixes of the different event types. Keep in mind that if you've chosen to generate the event types based on a template, the suffixes are pre-filled with the event names of the template. You can now preview the list of events that will be generated, along with the names of any assignees or reviewers, before completing the process. The full list of auto-generated events shows in a hierarchy, with each task contained within the overall process. When you review the details for one of the tasks, you can see that the context is restricted to the member on which the task is based, meaning that the user's view of any associated files will show the data only for that member. Here, you can also refine the events further, such as by adding other people, defining the appropriate users as assignees, reviewers, or viewers, or adjusting the settings you previously selected in the wizard. You can also add other tasks manually to capture additional work, such as reviewing the results of the overall process once the other tasks are complete. In this case, the task is dependent on the successful completion of the auto-generated tasks and is due after they are. Once you've created the review task, you must assign it to a user. You can use the same process to capture steps such as locking the data to prevent further changes once the individual tasks are complete. Like the review task, the data locking task is dependent on the successful completion of the previous event. For this type of task, you must also specify the model for which the data will be locked. Your data locking preferences are stored in the model, but can be refined here. Once the entire process is set up to meet your requirements, you can activate it manually, or if the setting is enabled, have it start automatically on the start date. Activating the process kicks off the related tasks, meaning that assignees will receive emails and notifications informing them of the work to be done. You can watch the How to Complete a Planning Workflow using the calendar video for details on how to carry out that workflow. And for more information on how to create calendar events in SAP Analytics Cloud, check out the help topic links in the description and try it for yourself today.